Hey guys, welcome back. This is Archana here, and as you know from the title, I'm back with another DIY. So today in this video, I'm going to show you how to make super simple rust paste at home. So for this, you're gonna need fine sand. It's not that fine, but little bit fine, and then homemade texture paste and some glue. These are basic ingredients for the rust paste. So here I took empty container. And I'm going to add 1.5 spoon of this sand and little bit more than 1/2 spoon of texture paste, and after that 1/2 spoon of glue. So in this video, I'm going to create 3 shades of rust paste, and for all these 3 shades, these basic ingredients will be same, that is fine sand, texture paste and glue, and only the paint shade will be different. So to make first shade, I added dark brown acrylic paint, and after that give it a good mix. I want this first shade a bit darker, so after this I'm just going to add 2 or 3 drops of black acrylic paint. And I was not convinced the shade I got here, so I went ahead and added few more brown acrylic paint in this paste. To make another shade of this rust paste, I took empty container and added 1 spoon of fine sand and 1/2 spoon of homemade texture paste, and also I'm going to add 1/2 spoon of glue. So as I said earlier, these 3 things are basic ingredients to make any shade of rust paste. Next, I added a few drops of orange acrylic paint and 1/2 spoon of brown acrylic paint, and give it a good mix. Thank you. last but not the least, to make final shade, I took all these three ingredients again and added only brown acrylic paint and give it a mix so that I can have a brownish shade of this rust paste. And these rust paste are completely experimental, so I will just list down all the ingredients and exact measurement of color and texture paste and sand in the description box below, so don't forget to check that out. I just love the yummy shades of this rust paste I got here, and now it's time to give it a try and check how it will go on the project. So here I took cardboard and just gluing down the jigsaw pieces randomly using hot glue gun. And while this process, I absolutely forgot that I wanted to have black background to have a rusty look further, but I just use white gesso. So you don't have to follow this process at all. You can use black gesso or black acrylic paint to prime the surface directly. And to apply this rust paste, I use really stiff brush so that brush can grab the graininess of the paste and spread it on the project easily. It's really simple and easy to choose which color to apply and where to apply. For example, if you want to show shading or depth in your project, then just go for the darker shade, or if you want to have highlighting effect, then just go for the lighter shade. And this way you can create highlighting and depth in your project easily. And while applying this rust paste, I feel that if I give that patina effect, then this rusty look will be complete. So I choose two acrylic color, that is sky blue color and leaf green color, that is the lighter shade of green color, and I mix this two color together, and I got the desired shade of patina effect. And then what I did, that I just use this color randomly, that to a very little bit, and to apply this color I took a little bit more amount of water in the brush and just spread these around the edges and here and there, as you can see in this video. Thank you. Hope you guys like and give it a try to this inexpensive rust paste. And if you try this, then don't forget to share with me. All my social media links are in the description box below. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will be back with another project soon. Till then, bye bye, take care and happy crafting.